Hello, everybody, and welcome to the final part of the God Willow Tree tutorial. Today, we're going to be going over the tree's leaves and the roots. So, I'm going to go ahead and do the roots first, and then we'll change the color of the tree, and we'll go from there. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with this. So, what I'm going to do is get my logs here. Change my speed to 1, and maybe smooth this out just a tad. I'm just going to do the roots by hand. I could do them with Voxel or with World Edit if I wanted to, but I think it's easier to just do them by hand, personally, so that's what I'm going to do. Get rid of this dirt really quick. So what we're going to do is take this and go out a ways further and then into the ground here. Okay. I'm going to thicken it out so it matches up with the rest of the tree. Okay. And the other side. Near the end here, I'm going to want to go into the ground so that it looks like it's going into the ground. But just a little bit. Okay, so there's one root. Go ahead and make a root kind of right here where this pops out just because it looks like there should be a root there. Maybe curve this one a little bit. All right. And roots are, I might mention, they are optional. You do not have to put a root. Not all trees have roots like this anyway. So that is completely up to you. If you're not going to put roots, though, I would make the bottom of the tree still look like it actually goes into the ground. Maybe by, like, adding some parts that go under like that, or maybe some parts that do this. You know, just some small effects to make it look like it still goes into the ground. It's not just smack on there. Okay, but I choose to do roots just because I really like how roots look usually. Just if you are going to do roots, make sure you do not do them with World Edit and just leave it as some balls. That pretty much goes for the entire tree. Don't just do the entire tree with World Edit and leave it so that it's balls. You don't want there to be visible spheres, or that adds some pretty bad effect to the tree, at least in my opinion. Makes the tree look not like a real tree. Alright. And get this into the ground here a little here. And okay. Maybe one more root going out that way. Right over here. So over here, going this way. And we're gonna lift it up here, come up into the tree. Make sure it blends with the tree, just like the other ones. Okay, and then give it a little chunkiness. Make it fat, and yes, that was a fat joke. Okay. Now that once we've done the roots, we're going to fly and select the tree and change all these logs to, I think I'm going to go with darker logs just because of the willow tree that we used, which is also right over the next screen, which I'll show you in a second. As soon as I finish this root, eventually here. Oops. Okay. So that should do it. Let me get speed 10. Let me look at the other tree right quick. So this is the other tree. It seems to be pretty dark wood. So we'll go with dark wood. And, all right, Let's go over here. Just post one, and I hope this doesn't crash the server. Or we're going to have to edit that out. Okay. Post two, replace 17, 17. I'm going to try 17, 13, and then we're going to also see what 16, 213 looks like. The other kind of dark wood. So let's this all load up. Slowly replace itself here. Okay. And forgot to. That's okay. We'll do that in a second. Or I'll do that later. Just make sure when you select it that you select the ground too, if you put any logs in the ground like I did. Okay. So that's what that looks like. Now let's try the other kind of wood, which I think might actually look better. Place 17 with 16213, which is the other kind of dark wood. It is this. Ooh, that's actually kind of cool. I like it. It's not too much different. Still got darkness to it. Almost looks dead, but once we put the leaves on it, it's gonna look just fine. All right. So now, onto the leaves. The fun part. So as you can see, I made one of these leaf things. I actually spent a good hour or so trying to figure out how to make leaves for this tree, and I think I figured out a pretty good way to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and explain how I did this. Let me up one. Okay, so what I did is I figured these branches are about where I made them go down are about five long, five or six. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make that down part really quick. One, two, three, four, five. Okay. And maybe I'll do six for this one. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to put the leaves around this just a little bit, kind of randomly. Okay. And then I'm going to get here. I'm going to go down, just kind of curve it around. We're going to go this way, this way, this way, and eventually get back to the center. So as you can see, it's curves and stuff. I'm going to make this one a little shorter than this one because I want different lengths. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make two of these. So eventually I'll have three different kind of branches I can use, which is plenty for this entire tree. We're just going to world edit a bunch of these all over the place. You can make four if you really want, which is okay. Don't worry, you can actually make one per branch if you really wanted, which I would actually advise four if you had the patience to do that. I don't, so what I'm going to do is this. Okay, and now once I did that, I just kind of made these little things coming off of this branch, going all over the place, maybe some with two going down there. So this is that. That over here. Oops. And I'm just going to do this going all the way down, spinning around. One right here, maybe. And then I'm going to go back up, make some more, a little bit more, maybe. Don't worry if they overlap a little bit. It's completely fine. Just make them kind of random. Don't make them even. You don't want even. Trees are never even. I don't like even trees. Even Steven. Make one right here. I like making them coming off of the little like lips I made. Makes it look nice. Okay. So there's that one. Make one more and then we'll make, or we'll start pasting them in. So let's go ahead and up one. Okay. I'll make this one with five. And I'll make this one a little bit longer again. So we're going to go one, two, three, four, maybe two here, here, here. That sounds about right. Okay. And then maybe one up on top. So that it covers that branch. Okay. Now I'm going to go, oops, get rid of that. Go down the center here, go this way. Maybe twice this way, just cause. Back once, over to the right, over to the left, Over to the right. Over to the right. No, let's go over this way. Over this way. Okay. So that one spins around a bunch. Point is to not make it completely straight. I mean, you could, I guess, if you really wanted, but it might not look as natural if you make it straight. And then I'm going to get rid of these that connect them. Okay. And go back up and start making these little bad boys. Okay, let's go down one more there. So we'll do that. Do one come off of this. Do one here. Another one here. Another one here. Oops. Let the fire join the game. Do one here. One here. All right, and we're just going to go all the way down again with this. Oops, there we go. There we go. And make sure this all connects up. I don't want any that do this because that leaves a pattern in them. I could, if it's okay if you do accidentally make one or two, it's not gonna, you're not really gonna see it anyway. But I just like to not try and do that just because patterns don't look as good in trees. And if you make a bunch of them, you'll definitely notice. And a bunch of the patterns, anyway. Okay. A little bit more here. Just much day. Maybe make some of these come with two, just so it's more random. They're not all the same. Maybe one over here. Okay. Now we got that. Now we got our three branches. Now I'm going to go ahead and select one of them. So let's select this one. And I'm probably going to speed up the video once I start pasting them in, and I show you how to do that. Select it. Okay. Go up to the top here. Up, 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 up. Okay, we're going to get in the middle of this, and we're going to fly up where the top of the branch would be. So we're going to assume there's a log about right here. Okay, we're going to fly up on top of that. Get rid of that real quick. / copy it up right here. Okay, and now we're going to paste it on in. Paste, I say. All right, now that we have that pasted in, ooh, that voice crack, excuse me. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and start rotating it around and pasting it in other places. So this is the part that starts taking forever, 90, paste minus A, and then we're just going to keep doing that, and eventually we'll have these branches full. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start getting different ones of these. So I'm going to maybe get this one, the shorter one here, this one, and I'm going to paste this one in there too. What I'm going to do, though, for the most part, is try to get some consistency in the lengths. So I don't want to just paste this one everywhere, or I don't want to paste them just randomly, is what I'm basically saying. So right here, copy. So for the shorter ones, I'm probably going to find another like branch part here. So like I'll paste it on these two, six branches, and that'll be where the shorter ones will go. And I'll pick like different systems for the shorter branches and different systems for the longer branches. Whoa, that's a person. Okay. So paste minus A. It's going to rotate it 90. Paste minus A. And it's really easy if you just hit the up arrow a couple times. Whoops. And rotate it. Rotate 90. Paste minus A. Rotate 90. Paste minus A. And It's cool because if you have the branches, or you have these little stem parts, or the branches come down a different length, that means these parts are different lengths. So it looks like I have one branch or one different thing of leaves right there, and it looks like there's a bunch of different kind of leaves, which is a good thing. And what I'm going to do is, just to make sure that this is a little bit thicker, is I'm probably just going to put like maybe a branch right, or some leaves right here in the middle, just so that it fills in for a little bit. And I'm going to do that, and we're going to go ahead and pause the video, or not pause the video, we're going to speed up the video, and we're going to go from there. So that was fun. I cut out some of that because it started to get really repetitive, and I think you guys get the gist. So now what we're going to do is add some leaves to this top part, because as you can see, this part over here looks kind of bland and it looks kind of weird to me anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do what I do with every tree, and we're going to mask 0, and then we're going to be our sphere. 10%, 18, 12, or yeah, 12, and then 90% 0. And we're gonna make this brush size about 3. So now I'm gonna go over the whole tree, and I'm basically just gonna do this. I might make this 4, actually, because 4 will go quicker. And I'm just gonna click on every little part where the branches are, smaller on the smaller branches. I'm not gonna click like over here. I don't need that. That doesn't really make sense to me. Just on these smaller branches here, and I'm gonna try to make it look like there's not really any difference. So basically all this does is add a little bit of a effect to it, so that it looks like the leaves aren't just coming off of it. It looks like there actually are a bunch of leaves. So I'll speed up the video again really quickly, and you'll get to see all that. So yeah, here we go. We are forever learning, one step at a time. As long as the world is turning, I'll be by your side. All right, and that would do it. So, it's pretty basic. All I'm doing is really just kind of covering up some things. If you missed a couple, that's totally fine. It actually adds a nice natural effect if you miss some. Even if you miss some, like, pasting or whatever, and for the leaves, that's totally fine. Don't worry about it. If it looks full, like this does, you have pretty much done all you can do, or all you need to do. This is pretty much all I'm going to do with this tree, actually. And that would pretty much conclude this tutorial. So thank you guys for watching. I will have a download link and probably be posting this to Planet Minecraft at one point. So look forward to that. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you comment, like, subscribe, and all that fun stuff. See ya.